It goes like this, the Lord. Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Please stand and greet those around you. Parish. We'll begin our celebration with song number 86, Hark the Herald Angels Sing, song number 86.
Oh, pray, Almighty God, that as we are bathed in the new radiance of your incarnate word, the light of faith which illumines our minds, may also shine through in our deeds. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Now, Isabel will lead us in our reading.
A reading from the book of Prophet Isaiah. See, the Lord proclaims to the ends of the earth. Say to daughter Zion, your Savior comes. Here is his reward with him, he recompensed before him. They shall be called the holy people, the redeemed of the Lord. And you shall be called repentant, a city that is not forsaken, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. When the angels went away from them to heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go then to Bethlehem to see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went in haste and found Mary and Joseph and the infant lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known the message that had been told them about this child. All who heard it were amazed by what had been told them by the shepherds. And Mary kept all these things, reflecting on them in her heart. Then the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, just as it had been told to them. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We'd like to invite the young people to come up here and sit on the steps and be part of the homily if you'd like, so please come on up. Out there, and I'm missing my sheep, and he's hard to find because he's white, and it snowed last night. Well, he's been missing actually since Sunday. Have any of you seen him? Have you looked around? Have you spotted him? What's his name anyway? Kevin? Inky, you're right. You know why we call him Inky? Because he's always getting out of the pen. Good as it gets. Let's look around for him. Inky, where are you? Oh, I think I see him. He's in the trees here. He's cold too because he's wearing a scarf. Why, it's a Chicago Bear scarf. I thought you'd be a St. Louis Rams man. Why are you wearing a bear scarf? He says he's been lost since Sunday and so have the Bears. Every Sunday. I guess those Vikings got an early Christmas present, didn't they? Go Vikings! You go sit down. Go over here, okay. Hey, Tyler, I'm glad you're up here, too. Well, you know, hearing that story about Christmas, a long time ago, the shepherds were out, and we were keeping watch over our flocks, and this really big angel appeared. And he said, "You need to go to a certain town." Does anybody know what town they were supposed to go to? Bethlehem, that's right. And we were looking for a certain woman who had just had a little baby. What was the woman's name, Nathan? Mary. And what's her husband's name, Kevin? Joseph, that's right. So, do you think I should, I thought, if I'm looking for a woman who's about to have a baby, maybe I should go to the hotel. Should I go to the inn in Bethlehem? No. Why shouldn't I? Well, I know why I shouldn't go to the inn, because I'm a shepherd and they don't like putting us up, and because certain people were around don't smell very good. I didn't want him to hear that part. Well, it was just like they said, we couldn't go to the inn, so they said, where do you think we should go to find this woman and her new baby and her husband, Quinn?
In a stable.
In a stable, right. And so we went over to the stable, and it was just like the angel said. There was Mary, and there was Joseph, and there was the baby. And I looked in that stable, and I know what it's like to be out with the animals, and it's, you know, it's cold, and it's dark, and it's not very comfortable, but that really wasn't the baby's biggest problem. You know what the baby's biggest problem was? Donkey breath. Once we got past that, it looked like the baby wanted to say something. So I went over there. Hinky and I went over there and we listened really closely. And you know what he told us? He told us. Well, he was a baby. He couldn't talk very well yet. And so Hinky said, well, we should bring gifts. Hinky, where are you going to go on Christmas Day and get gifts? He says, Walmart. He said he already had a couple of presents. How about if we look around here? Do you see any presents around here? It's okay. It's okay to look behind that curtain. Okay. Oh, there's gifts right there. Well, let's look at that big one, Katie. You want to open it? Maybe that's the one for the baby Jesus. That's the biggest one. Lily, you want to come over here and open one too? Kevin, how about you let her open that one when we're ready? Let's look and see what's in this big one though. Mouthwash. Hey, you're getting the baby Jesus mouthwash? He says, no. Who do you bet it's for? The donkey, you're right. We'll put it by the donkey then. What's in that other one? It's a heart. Inky, maybe that's a good idea. Is this one for the baby Jesus? Don't you think a good Christmas present for the baby Jesus is if we give him our heart? Do you think that's a good idea, Kyler? All right, that's what we'll do. We'll put that over here too. Well, I hope that's what you can do. I hope as you get older, you can keep giving Jesus your heart. How about if we stand up now? I think this looks like a good choir here. Let's see. How about, are we ready for, which one are we ready for? Whatever we want. Do you know the song, Away with the Manager? How about Away, what is it, Kale? Away in a manger. Okay, I was close. How about if we sing that one? Do you know that one better? Okay. A one, a two, a three. In a manger with no crib or a bed, not when the Lord Jesus lay down. Zoe and Madison and Ryan and Kevin and Katie and Nathan and Kale and Quinn and Kyler. Let's give them a round of applause. Let's stand to profess our faith. Something that the ritual calls for us to do, if you are able, is when we get to the part of the creed where we pray, He came down from heaven and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. We're asked to kneel for the feast of Christmas. So how about if we kneel during that part if you're able? I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through Him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, He came down to heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, He was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and His kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. As we ponder the amazing mystery of God's heavenly word sent to us as Jesus, who is both God and human, we speak our own words of continuing need for ourselves and for the whole world.
We pray that people in our church and country might have greater respect for the sacredness of life and the dignity of every person, for God's plan for marriage and family, and for true religious liberty. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the light of peace to dwell amid those in the darkness of war or violence across the world, in our nation and in our families. And for all who are migrating and homeless, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those who will be missing deceased family members and friends this year. May they be comforted in knowing that their loved ones will be spending Christmas in eternity this year. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those who await the birth of children, both their own or through adoption. May the Blessed Virgin Mary intercede for a safe birth and healthy child, and that parents and grandparents will pass on their faith and love as their greatest inheritance. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the sick and the lonely, especially those who will have no one with whom to celebrate, that through the Nativity of Christ they may find relief in mind and body. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those who will provide the services we need during the holidays, for those who must work today to assure our safety, health, and well-being. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all gathered here around Christ in this holy place, and for our loved ones who are not with us now. And this morning we remember in the rites. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
O wondrous God, give us joy in this celebration of the birth of your Son. Hear these prayers that we may sing with the angels your glory and praise always. We pray all this through Christ our Lord. The children can come up now with Carol.
present our gifts, let's join together in song number 108. First Noel number 108.
Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in the mystery of the Word made flesh, a new light of your glory has shone upon the eyes of our mind, so that as we recognize in him God made visible, we may be caught up through him in love of things invisible. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. He forgave sinners and taught us to forgive each other. He loved everyone and showed us how to be kind. He took children in his arms and blessed them. God our Father, all over the world, your people praise you. So now we pray with the whole church, with Francis our Pope and Michael our Bishop, in heaven the Blessed Virgin Mary, her husband Saint Joseph, the apostles, and all the saints always sing your praise. God, our Father, you are most holy, and we want to show you that we are grateful. We bring you bread and wine, and ask you to send your Holy Spirit to make these gifts the body and blood of Jesus, your Son. Then we can offer to you what you have given to us. On the night before he died, Jesus was having supper with his apostles. He took bread from the table. He gave you thanks and praise. Then he broke the bread, gave it to his friends, and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." When supper was ended, Jesus took the cup that was filled with wine. He thanked you, gave it to his friends, and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins." Then he said to them, "Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Father, the bread that gives us life and the cup that saves us. Jesus brings us to you. Welcome us as you welcome him. Heavenly Father, because you love us, you invite us to come to your table. Fill us with the joy of the Holy Spirit as we receive the body and blood of your Son. Lord, you never forget any of your children. We ask you to take care of those we love, especially those we think of now. And we pray for those who have died. And we pray for you in a special way. You're missing somebody, or maybe this is even your first Christmas without them. May they all rest in the peace of Christ. Lord, remember everyone who is suffering from pain or sorrow. Remember Christians everywhere and all other people in the world. We are filled with wonder and praise when we see what you do for us through Jesus, your Son. And so we sing. From him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other sense I am.
we receive the body and the blood of Christ, let's join together in song number 109 and 110, Child of the Poor, What Child Is This?
Thank you.
Lau family sign them on the tree. Let's see, Michelle and Dennis are the parents. And I'm glad you used whatever parental authority you had to say you had to be here at 10 o'clock on Christmas Day. So thanks. And this is my Christmas present for the parish or for me? Okay, for you, okay. I think we all liked it too. There's Sandy and Shelby and Shaughnessy and Stephanie and Sydney and Dennis and Devin. And then we have David and Derek and Dave. So thanks everybody for being here today. I guess as long as I'm on announcements, we wanted every household to have a book, Rediscover Jesus by Matthew Kelly. There's very short chapters, there's discussion questions, I think it's a book that you'll really enjoy if you take a look at it. So we have one per household, so, and our guests that are here, if you'd like one for your household, I think we have enough, so you're welcome to take one if you haven't received one already. Be sure to get a bulletin. We have the same bulletins for all today and the next 2 days too, so it's the same bulletin from now until Sunday. But we have announcements in there about Masses next week, which next Friday is a holy day, the feast of Mary, the Mother of God, on New Year's Day. So we have Masses on Thursday and Friday for that holy day. We have red envelopes in the pews, and those have projects listed that we hope to, some are wish lists, but some are projects that we have to do, like a new section of the roof over the grade school. So if you'd like to help with any of those projects, just take a red envelope and you can get it back to us at your convenience. We welcome again all of our guests, and if any of you are new to this area and you're looking for a parish to join, we hope you'll consider us. So if you're a guest that lives elsewhere, we hope you can come back and join us again soon. And on behalf of Deacon Vic and our parish staff, I'd like to wish all of you a Merry Christmas. Let us pray. Grant, O merciful God, that just as the Savior of the world born this day is the author of divine generation for us, so he may be the giver even of immortality, who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Thanks be to God. Before we have our final song, we have a huge back family up in the balcony, and Brian's been recording the Mass. And so, Brian, is it safe for me to tell people they can go on our website, they can get a live stream on that? Okay, or not the live stream, excuse me, replaying. Brian's willing to take a couple hours to download it first, so. But maybe sometime by tomorrow or Sunday, if you wanted to watch the Mass, maybe with somebody who shut in, you could get it on a laptop or an iPad or a computer's device like that. So thanks a lot for doing that. So we've got the Christmas Mass recorded. Now I think we're ready for the final song.
Let's join together in song number 78, Joy to the World, number 78.
Thank you. Navidad, los miembros de la comunidad de España.